Hi, horse people! Well, let's look at ignorant horse information number 147. Here's a clue that you're going to get bad information. Purple rope, buckle, pink halter, pain. Okay, if you can't put those clues together, then you're on the wrong freaking channel anyway. But I mean, this is just freaking ridiculous. This girl is making an educational video, talking nice words, making people think this is a good thing. Look at the knot on this freaking rope halter. This is not a correct tie for a rope halter. And the reason why you tie a rope halter a certain way is so when a horse pulls or gets tightened, you can get it undone. When you start doing these magical loop-de-loop pretty pink knots, if a horse pulls, you can't get it off. Then if they get in trouble and they get caught, you have to cut it off. And then they're thrashing and you end up cutting them. So people may go, well, Rick, whatever does it make if it's not? You're just picking on pink. Shut up, you freaking crybabies. I'm not picking on pink. I'm picking on ignorance. When you don't do things right, the horse pays. Just like this stupid video.
Bridle. I don't use it for training. I just use it for emergency restraint, usually for medical stuff. So you take a piece of baling twine, aka hay string.
Baling twine, hay string. And this rope is run on top of the teeth and under the gum, creating extremely pain. It's called a gum line. She calls it a freaking war bridle. It's not a war bridle. It's a gum pain device. And people will use ropes, baling twine, wire, or chains with this ignorance. And watch when she explains it. She'll make it sound all nice and sweet. It releases endorphins. It rubs against. Yeah. You know what? I should have told all the suspects when I hit them with my police baton when I was working that, oh yeah, the baton isn't to hurt you. It's to relieve endorphins so you'll relax. Because that's what she tells people. You put a freaking thin piece of wire, hay string, pain device on a horse, sensitive gums, you tighten it up and create pain and stop blood flow, and somehow people, pink and purple, believe that if you say it releases endorphins and it feels good, it makes it okay. Unfreaking believable.
Put it around their head, underneath their upper lip, and that squeezes on pressure.
Can you not see the pain and discomfort in this horse's eyes? She's going to explain this discomfort and pain look as, see, he looks chill and relaxed. The endorphins are working. I mean, it's just crazy how you put a woman in pink explaining something with nice words, and you'll have 50,000 women saying she's smart, wonderful, powerful, empowered, brilliant, and such a great trainer. I mean, it's just crazy.
Pressure points behind their ears and on their gum releases endorphins in their brain and helps.
This horse is tearing. He's in so much pain. No, Rick, that's because of a fly. No, the pink halter releases endorphins, Rick. No. I put a rubber band here so it would be more comfortable. I mean, it's like shooting somebody with a machine gun and go, dude, I'm giving you some Band-Aids. What are you crying about? I'm helping you out. I just shot you with a machine gun. Here's a Band-Aid. Why are you mad at me? I'm trying to help. This is how stupid this is.
Calm them down. So her lips are all droopy. So she's nice and chill. So
nice and chill. Really?
So you put it on loose at first, and after a minute you tighten it, and then you wait another few minutes for the endorphins to really kick in, and then you can do your shot or whatever you need.
Oh, so you wait for the endorphins to kick in because it feels so good. Time somebody tells me something good for a horse, I go, if it's good for the horse, it should be good for you. Let's try it on you. Oh, no. My gums don't release endorphins. My gums release pain. But horse in pink and purple, their gums release endorphins and it feels good. Are you freaking kidding me?
Need to do. I use a heavy duty rubber band for comfort and safety.
For comfort and safety. Really? You're freaking creating pain and you're putting a thin piece of wire, rope, chain on a horse's sensitive gums and you're cranking it down on their head and putting intense pain. And somehow you're saying, I'm going to use a rubber band to make it comfortable. See, this young kid, and this sounds like a young kid, was told this by some other idiot who was probably told it by some other idiot, and it just gets passed down and passed down. Why? Because people can't call anybody an idiot anymore. Because you're being mean, you're being a bully, you're not being fair, you're picking on her because she's a woman. There's all these excuses to protect ignorance, and the horse suffers. It's just crazy.
And the ring allows it to adjust smoothly when I tighten it.
Oh, it adjusts smoothly when I tighten it. All these kind words and kind colors make the horse's pain somehow a good thing.
There's several names for this thing. I call it a war bridle. I don't use it for training, I just use it for.
It's not a war bridle. You go to my website, to my horseman tips page, and then scroll down. Okay, here it is. So if you go down here, what is a war bridle, and click on that, it will bring you to what is a war bridle. And so there's several different ways that you could put on a war bridle. It's not, a lot of people run it. It's just a quick way if you have a rope to where you can control a horse. So in this picture, you can put a loop. And basically, you just, it's not tight and it's not meant to do pain and it's not put on the gums. It's basically like a rope bit. You put a loop around a horse's mouth and then you run the other side of the loop, the rope through and down. So you can do it with a little rope. You put this little loop and the horse's mouth goes in here. Then you run the other end of the rope through, and then you can lead a horse. For an emergency, if you don't have a lead, if you had to ride a horse, you could jump on and ride him quick. You don't have to worry about a bridle and everything. I'm not saying that this is a good way to ride, but a war bridle doesn't have to be painful. I mean, you're still putting something in a horse's mouth. I would rather it be on the outside of his head, but this gives you a little bit more leverage. The lower you go down on a horse's head, the more leverage you got to turn and control and pull the horse and overpower it. And when you put things inside the mouth, the more power you have to create pain and discomfort so the horse doesn't fight as much when you pull and yank and make a horse do something. Whereas on the outside, you lose that leverage because it's higher up, it's spread over a larger area, and it doesn't create as much pain. So therefore, you have to know what you're doing and be able to train a horse without something in his mouth. And real quick on my site, if you go to thinklikeahorse.org, it says not secure because Google has made people pay. It cost me $147 a year if I want this to say secure. Does nothing else, but if I pay Google the ransom of $147 a year, I get my site to say secure. And then, because I've had people say, I went to your site, it said not secure, so I didn't want to enter it. I'm afraid I'm gonna. There ain't no viruses on my site. I run it. I'm the only one that uploads to it. I don't collect cookies. I don't track hits. I don't do anything. I put information out there to be shared. So, because Google wants their $147 ransom, I refuse to pay them. It says not secure. Don't worry about that. I'm not tracking you or trying to do anything. Anyway, you can go to my site and on the front page, if you want to search something on my site, just scroll down and right here, if you put in war bridle, it'll take you to the page. Yeah, here's another type. Again, a war bridle is basically putting something in the horse's mouth other than they've bitten a head stall in order to ride it. So in this picture, they've just put a loop around and they've put a little slide thing. I forgot what you call that. It's not a concho. Maybe it is a concho. But anyway, you slide this up and down like you do on a hobble. And that way, when you slide it up, you can connect reins to it and you can ride. Riding like this for any long period, especially if you've got very hard hands, you're going to tear up the horse's jaw and jawline. So, especially with this type of rope, this rope is very stiff and hard. Here's someone with a cute pink little horse. Oh, I'm surprised the hair isn't braid, but at least it's trimmed nice. Anyway, Somebody's just put like a regular leather, piece of leather around a horse's bottom jaw. Now, this can be dangerous because when you put this on here, you're cutting off blood supply to the lower lip. And you've seen a lot of horses with droopy lip. Sometimes that can be from an aggressive bit hurting. People put chains underneath their bits to dig into the horse's jaw. And, or they put in, you know, a little leather. And I can't think of the proper term right now for a, shit. Anyway, there's another type of war bridle. They put a rope through it. Here's a picture of somebody doing a rope bridle with a piece of leather. They've tied it, made the loop like the rope, ran it around, and ran it back up around. And again, if you get a horse that you have nothing to control it with and you need to control it, this works pretty good for an emergency quick thing. This picture's not a war bridle. It's a gum line. They've ran a rope, twisted it around the horse's head from his neck, and then up under the gum, put it through here, and pulled forward. So when you pull here, it increases pressure here, putting pressure on the sensitive gums, cutting off blood supply to the upper lip, and it makes the horse listen. It also, because the way they've wired it, it also puts pressure here, which gags the horse. So by pulling here, you're putting pressure here and here. Not a war bridle, more like a torture bridle or a torture gum line. Farriers use common techniques like this to control horses. This is probably a good way to move a horse in a pasture. You simply loop it over the horse's head, pull the rope through here. Now when I pull here or lead the horse, it puts a little pressure on top of his nose and it puts a little pressure on the back and it puts pressure under the chin. So it gives a pulling pressure here and a pulling pressure here and you can lead a horse. This is what's called an emergency halter to where you lead a horse and you know, when you don't have anything else, but you got a rope in your hand, which is why, you know, I carry a rope always on my saddle because it comes in handy for a lot of things, such as if I run across a horse like this. And I guess they're selling these little things on Amazon as a war bridle to where this just slides up and down. You put it underneath your mouth, you know, the lower horse, that one picture I showed, and you connect your reins here. I'm not a fan of this. To me, this is nothing more than a rope bit that hurts a horse. Damn, here's a shocker. They got it in pink. Wow. Who could have predicted that? Man, the more I'm looking at Google pictures of war bridles, this image keeps coming up, so these must be pretty damn popular. Look, this is another gimmick that's cool. It makes people say, oh, I don't need a bit. Oh, I can ride my horse with no halter. Oh, it looks cool, and I'll be different. It's still a pain device inside a horse's mouth with rope rubbing on sensitive gum, tongue, cheek, and other area inside, not to mention sanitation. Every time you pull it in and out, it's got saliva and grass and dirty, and I guarantee you most people don't wash them. So, I mean, anytime you start doing this, it's not good for the horse. I just don't understand why you just can't ride in a freaking rope halter or a leather halter or whatever and learn how to have soft hands and control your horse without having something in his mouth to make you feel powerful, strong, and cool. But anyway, that's a war bridle versus a gum line, and we'll end that there. I'm tired of looking at poor horses getting abused with pretty colors and pretty names. We'll end that there. Buddy Mr. T, you're good boys.